strong. Come on, Bart. Ah! 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 Get it! Good shit.
He only spit.
Hey, what up, guys? Today we're gonna stray a little bit away from powerlifting. You guys know I'm working on an action movie, so I do want to get into shape. I want to be more well-rounded. So we got Rulk here. He trains SEAL teams, celebrities, first responders, and he's gonna run me through a series of workouts that's probably gonna kick my ass. What kind of system?
It's gonna be this RFT, raw functional training. We're gonna go through 9 movement patterns today. It's a level 1 warm up.
Level and, 1?
Yeah, level 1, bro. All
right. You mean level 10?
Level 39.
Yeah.
Level 39, of course. Bart starts at level 39. He doesn't fuck around.
Okay. So what are the first things that we're gonna run through?
We'll do some crawls. Okay. Do some side crawls. Do some jumps, some hops, some different movements, some sit-throughs. I'll show it all to you, bro.
Okay.
We'll break it all down. We'll break it all down.
Sounds easy.
You ready, dog?
Yeah.
Let's do it.
Knees low, keep that table. Nice and slow. Keep those knees a little wide. When you go reverse, knees nice and up. There it is. Keep that knee to hip ratio wide. Here we go. It's your only day of the last one on the mat.
The last one.
Let's go.
So awkward. I feel like I'm relearning how to move. Oh, my leg.
Come on, baby, let's go. Beautiful. Here we go. Next one, 75%. Okay? Opposite 75% now. A little bit faster. We're going on this, so watch it. Send my knees.
They come out a little wider.
How was it easy the first time?
It's not easy, dude.
Oh. Yes, sir. Oh. Yes, sir. First movement down. 8 to go.
Next one, side crawl. So, body position on this. Imagine there's a rod going from my shoulder girdle down to my hip girdle, like parallel line. I'm gonna have it facing the barbell brigade.
Yeah.
I'm gonna come down. Crawl positioning is similar to 75%. Out the table, even table. 50% of each are the knees. 75% of the as the don't cross your hands. Don't cross your hands. And no hands. Okay, let's go. Good. Knees nice and low on the ground. Kick your feet back just a little bit. There it is. Keep the parallel line. Hit the shoulders together. Come on, Bart. Knees lower, get those knees lower, there it is. Breathe, bro, breathe.
Oh.
Beautiful! Oh. Yeah, this is second funny, but she's looking now. Come on, boss!
Come on, Bart, come on.
Come on, Bart. Yes, you get this, you get this. Come on. Yes, sir. Beautiful. Beautiful.
My quads are nice, come on.
Here we go, brother. Good shit. Good shit, brother. Come on. Here we go. Get over. Come on, here we go. Okay. Next one's called down here. This is one. Back up. Your toes are forward, close the door. It's two movements now. It's a vertical jump. Command. Out.
Let's go, Bart, come on.
Let's go, Bart, come on.
Come on, Bart.
Let's go, come on. Come on, bro. Come on, here we go. There it is, come on. Sit down. Sit down.
How do you feel?
Oh, my quads are on fire. I can't even feel them. God damn! I can't feel my quads.
That's normal. That's normal. You're fine. You're fine. Here we go. So next one, hop scotch. So imagine hop scotch. I'm going to do it again. Hop scotch pattern. One square, two square, one square, two square. I'm jumping to you. So right foot up. Okay, 80% weight distribution on that lead leg. Okay? Drive it into that heel. It's almost like a reverse lunge. Okay? Drive it back with 80% in here. 20 here. Imagine the box in the front of this one. I'm jumping up. Land on two box. That's one. So one to two, one to two, one to two. Breathe.
So here.
right now. The key issue is like, it's like a squat. 90 degrees, and you're familiar with this movement, is your high point. You gotta stay under 90 degrees. Chest up, like you're in a squat.
God damn.
Okay? Just try, stay low. Stay low. All the way, okay? Let's go. I'll do this with you, bro. All right, brother, here we go. That's the time. Get a burn. Here. Ready? Go. Here we go. Good. Come on, Bart. Stay low, stay low, stay low. Get there, bro, get there. Get there, Bart, get there. Attaboy. Good shit.
Oh, my God. Nice.
Oh my God. Good shit, baby.
How many more are there?
Two more.
Two more. Oh, and two more, Bart.
How are cops supposed to do their jobs if they're doing this first? No wonder cops eat donuts.
You're savage, bro.
I am, okay? Savage. Shit.
Let's get this. Here we go.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. That was a good 5-hour workout so far.
Yeah, so we're gonna do this one. Three verts on each cone. So three jumps?
Yeah.
Hostage. Three jumps? Hostage. Don't you open up
that window? No.
In place, in place. Come on. Come on, Bart. Three, baby. Let's go. Come on. Tell the mind to shut the fuck up. Let's go. Come on.
Shut the fuck
Let's
up.
Go. Come on. Get it. Get down low. Three last one. Three. Finish the three. Come on, Bart. Finish the three. Here we go. Come on, Bart. Come on, come on. Ah. Ah. Hey.
Come on.
Lead boss, come on. Lead for the front door. Let's get this shit. Right now, doggy, come on. Let's go.
All right, let's go. Come on.
Let's do this shit. Three.
He only spit.
Fuck yeah, Mark. Come on, one more. One last round.
Join to all
the How long?
Come on, Mark.
Go, Mark.
One last round, brother. One last round. Let's get this, Mark. Come on. Come on, boss. You got this shit, baby. Let's go. Come on. Let's get up. Come on. Last one. Come on. Get up and get there. Get up and get there. Get up and get there. Come on. Deep breath. Enjoy your system.
Can you just drag it down?
I don't know. I didn't
watch
see it.
Me. Turn around. Just watch me while you relax.
Bart.
Watch me while you relax, brother.
Last one, Bart. Come on.
That's that arrow. Stop. You got this, Bart. Come on. Come on. You're doing good, baby. Let's go. Last one. Let's finish strong. Good. Just watch this, Bart. This is right here. Oh, watch it.
That's the next one, bro.
You drive home.
Almost there, bro. Come on.
Come on right now, baby. Let's go. Drive through. Come on, baby. Let's go. Attaboy. Get there. Get there. Good shit, Bart. Good shit, Bart. Fuck yeah, baby. Shit.
You ready?
Drive! Drive! Everyone's counting on you, Bart. Finish this shit. Let's go, my brother. Let's go. Come on. Come on. We got this.
How many rounds do your athletes usually do?
This is the warm-up progression. So you should just warm up. We're going to do this. This is the warm-up. We're going to do this. Mike did a good job, though. Watch your nervous system. So I'm going to go up again. Watch it. Control it.
How did that feel?
That was like the easiest thing I've ever done. Probably do that like 20 times, easily.
You know that was the warm-up?
Who warms up for this? Like fighters?
Yeah, it's warm-up.
That's why I stick to powerlifting. It's one rep.
Crush it, bro. I'm so proud of you. You did so good. I'm proud of you.
Thank you.
Proud of you.
It's so nice. I died and you think I did a good job.
Watch your system. It's going to spike up a little. So I'm going to climb and walk around.
My stomach doesn't really know what's going on. It feels confused. The same thing with my breathing. It feels like I ran 20 miles back. I just did this a couple times. My body's like all fucked up right now. And then it feels like it's kind of dizzy. Like the earth is like rotating. But it feels crazy.
It's a weird feeling.
Yeah.
You used to get the feeling to push you super hard. It's just moving the movement power super hard.
The
brain doesn't
know
what's going on.
This one.
we're talking
So, my name is Rulk. The system training I do is raw functional training and RFT. Bart did it today. He worked through my first warm-up progression, which is like called the level one warm-up progression, which he did amazing on.
AKA level 39.
Yeah, AKA chamber 39.
Yeah.
But he did really, really well. It's just a series of movement patterns that he does. We went a little bit longer today, took a few things and changed the sequencing up a little bit, but he did phenomenal. He did phenomenal. You know, he's such an explosive athlete, has so much power and strength already. It was all about mobility and conditioning. And he did really, really well. I was very impressed.
Thank you so much. Are you flirting with me or?
Possibly. My foot is touching yours right now. You know, let me get it over. Oh, see. But super good, super good. So, I mean, like I said, my whole thing is about getting the system to adapt to specific movement patterns. Bart asked me to explain sequencing and what I do. And sequencing, basically, the best way to explain is if I told you say the alphabet to A to Z, you can say it because we're familiar with that coding and that sequence. But if I told you say it backwards, for every third letter, every sixth letter, it's gonna take you some time to figure out that coding, and your mind has to figure out that coding and adapt.
Which is something that you should know, like on the back of your hand. But when you take something like the squat or even a bear crawl, and then now you break it down into like mini steps and you like turn it around sideways, it just fucks your shit up.
Yeah, because you know the thing is, it's interesting is that there's so many things in play there, right? Not only just the sequencing and the movement patterns and adapting that way, but there's also just the breathing patterns and the blood flow is different on that. And you're in a position where you're moving in a way that you haven't been familiar moving. So there's that sensory stuff we talked about as well. So. Not only just your five senses, but your vestibular system, your proprioception is all being activated. So managing that is extremely challenging, along with pushing through cardio-wise. The funny thing is that when we do these types of movements, people freak out because they're like, hey, I'm not even sprinting, I'm not running hard, I'm not lifting any weight, yet I'm still being challenged, and I'm still freaking out, my body's freaking out a little bit. It's just, it's very common, you know?
Can you tell them about some of the stuff you do with the SEALs with like the blindfolding and then like the earplug and stuff?
Well, the sensory stuff is interesting because, you know, that's how we take in all information. So when I'm working with first responders or military or law enforcement, when you go into any situation, your five senses, your hearing, your visual acuity, smell, everything is given to play to process information. And the more efficient you can get at processing that information, the more effective you're gonna be, right? Applying your techniques, or the stronger you're gonna be, the faster you're gonna be, the more conditioned you're gonna be. So what we try to do is do sensory deprivation occasionally. What we'll do stuff is, you know, blindfold them, have them go through motions. We'll have them put earplugs in. We'll take away a sense, because if there's five senses, you take one away, the other four get heightened. And learning how to operate with four senses, with three senses, with two senses, with one sense. And people also forget about the other two senses, which the far near senses, which is proprioception, which is balance, and vestibular, which is, you know, that's when you get up, like today, when you start to feel dizzy. Yes, when you start to get dizzy. So managing all those senses and integrating that into the training is what's really challenging, because we focus so much on load training, athletes do, but general pop, even people that aren't in the military, first responders or elite athletes.
Everyone's lifting weights,
but it's a matter of if you can't move without load, you have no reason to move with load. So I try to tell people, let's focus on the mobility. Let's focus on getting your body moving and operating on a high level first before we operate and then put you into different situations. We were talking about before, kettlebell lifters, Olympic lifters, everyone could use it. My system is all about enhancing whatever you do. So if we do specifically Olympic lifting or strongman, we'll deconstruct those movement patterns. We'll design some curriculum specifically for your sport or whatever you're specifically training for, and we'll go from there. But the general warm-up progressions that we did today, those are just for everyone. And we can change those progressions.
That's for everyone?
We went hard for you because you're on that Bart Kwan level. You're like, that's like,
oh, okay. Yeah, thank you.
That's
thank
like
you,
the black, you. Yeah, like yeah, that's yeah. That's a high level. Yeah. That's a super high level.
That's
guys.
True.
But
that's
true. Yeah, I mean, like, for whoever, we can modify that. We modify that all the way to there's like one cone, or you know, people don't even move in one situation because all you
we
do is.
We should have just did like two or three
we
cones.
We should have done it. But you wanted to go 39th level, bro.
I know.
So you wanted to go 39th level, bro.
I know. Thank you so much.
Dude,
was crazy.
So good, bro. I'm so proud of you, bro.
Thanks.
So thanks for trying it. I know a lot of guys go through it. And it's funny because a lot of people, I think, they look at it, well, that looks easy. How come Bart's, he's acting? Other guys are like, oh, like, dude, he's really acting for the camera. You're not.
Hell no, that shit's fucking hard.
So that kind of training kind of reminds me of, so I used to wrestle in high school.
Yeah.
So it's a while ago, and we used to do like duck walks and bear crawls and stuff.
Yeah.
But everyone's doing it very like sloppily. You have like one coach and you have like 30 guys or whatever.
Right.
And then, but breaking it down, you know, and you're telling me to pretend like I have a cup of water on my back, don't spill that.
Right.
And now you're like focusing on all these fine motor skills.
Right.
And then I was also a former military in the Marines.
Nice.
And so that it just kind of brought me all the way back into those days. Right. And I'm just like, fuck, I remember this shit. This shit's so fucking hard, goddamn. But this was like on another level, because usually in both of those environments, you have partners. So like they come to you, you go back, and there's like rest periods.
Right.
But this was just bam, 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 bam. And it was cool to like go all the way back to that type of training.
Right.
Because like I always like, I like strength training.
Right.
But I think at the end of the day, like we're all human. Yeah. I want to be able to be a good human too. Right. I want to just be a good lifter. So this was really, really
And that's cool. The whole thing is about deconstructing movement patterns, right? And outside of using, everyone uses load, right? Load. But you can change it with tempo. You know, body plane positioning, all these different things we can change to make the body adapt than just hypertrophy training with just load weight. You know what I mean? So like you did today, but incorporating those and interfusing those and synergizing those together, that's where that next level is, right? Yeah. Taking your power that you build off of lifting and combining with this kind of a system is where you're gonna go.
So. Yeah.